didn't have that. And I had to sit Gabby down and I talked to her because I think, I mean, she's great, she's a business finance, she's very bright, she's helped me. So I know the quality of worker that she is. And so I gave her sort of the candid feedback and I said, what you need to do is you need to watch yourself. So go do mock interviews, have videotape and see how you come across. Because you're a slight person, smaller woman, maybe a little bit of the heels, maybe how you're standing. And we talked about just the physical presence of it, and then we talked about how she's perceived it. So it's at the end of the networking event. And it was interesting because she's working so hard at it, just so not in her nature. And she really stepped out of her shell, and I'm happy to report that she interviewed with another company at Target, and she was just aggressive like I had never seen her. And she was that, because I could say, now, you don't want to graduate and not have that job come in. She's so determined, I need to have that job because my family needs me to have that job. And she, the report I got back was she was amazing, she had prepared, she had the company, she was self-confident, the warm filler words, she just really knew herself. So what I learned from that experience was that she is probably the most humble person I know, but that sabotaged her, just like it sabotaged some of our other students. And when I think back in terms of my experience being at Univision, because I assume it's sort of like a Latino culture, but really there, when I went, at least in the late 90s, it was still very much Caucasians were the managers and those that interviewed you. And a lot of the Latinos were the secretaries. And I started noticing that, and it was about how you presented yourself. So a lot of the workshops that we're doing for our Latino students, particularly first generation, is that idea of how to present themselves and how to sell yourself. And it's really hard because it's like you're not supposed to do that. In our culture, it's sort of, well, who do you think you are? We say that a lot. And it's the idea that it's okay to say you are great at something, because you are, and you have the technical expertise to prove it and show it.
We're going to be mentoring, if those organizations are going to partner because of that conversation, right? See, so you got to think, you have to keep talking. You never know when you're going to make a connection so that you can, you know, connect and help each other. So we're going to be supplying some mentors for the U.S. students on resume building and interview skills. Did anybody want to talk about humility, or do you want to move on to another? Okay, go ahead, Tim.
I just wanted to comment that I don't think humility and self-confidence are mutually exclusive qualities. I think you can have tremendous self-confidence and believe in yourself and have pride in yourself and still have humility. And I think about my dad, who raised 11 children, worked at the same company for 40-some years in Los Angeles. Incredible pride in his ethnicity and in his culture and in his family, and yet one of the most humble people I've ever met. And so I think it's possible to blend those two characteristics. And I really identify with the PIE because I was raised to believe you do a good job, you do hard work, but things will come to you. Not so true. Okay, you gotta do a good job, do hard work, have the image of, what was the E? What is the E?
Exposure.
So the one thing I've never been good at is playing the corporate game and kissing up to the right people, because it feels disingenuous to me, and it makes me sick. So I've been willing to forego the advancement opportunity so that I can look myself in the mirror at the end of the day and know that I can kiss somebody, you know what, just to get up.
Okay. Rima, did you want to say something about humility? Hard work, okay, excellent. Because I actually think that one can be a competitive advantage. And so, I don't know if anybody, does anybody have a particularly strong goal?
Okay, you go. Well, as I mentioned to you, I actually was raised in both cultures, in the Japanese culture and the Mexican culture. And to my surprise, very similar. Our culture values are really amazingly similar. Hard working, for example, is one of those cultural values that we share with both cultures. The interesting thing, and this is something that the development training we do, we talk about an iceberg. So you know that the iceberg, you can only see the tip. But really, the most important part of the iceberg is underneath the water, what you don't see. So we talk about cultural values, right? You cannot see. Those are actually the most important part of the iceberg. And those are what all of us think of as the most important treasures that we have from our generations, from our families. Now, those cultural values make us unique in certain ways. So the humility, for example, that we're talking about, the hard-working ethic, the integrity that we have, all these are messages that we heard from our childhood, from our parents. So we see those behaviors, so that's part of the iceberg that we actually can see. But those behaviors, remember, that are seen by people that don't necessarily share our cultural values. So there are perceptions that are made of those behaviors that people see. Now, those perceptions can be, remember that those perceptions are the reality of those people, right? So the way I look, right, people immediately think, okay, see, she's Asian, she does martial arts, for example. Nerdy, I'm really good at math, which by the way, I was terrible at school. So, but immediately, people make these perceptions about me just because of how I see, how I am, what I look like. Now, that may not be my reality, so when I speak and I talk, I'm always like, wait a minute, she's not even behaving Asian, you know, what's her name? So, but it is important that we know that, because even though you know your reality, you know why you work hard, you know why you are humble, others may not understand that. And that happens a lot in corporate America. So, for example, the hardworking, the positive side is that, boy, you get things done. You find always a way to get things done, even if you don't have the resources that you need. That's just something that we do. However, when you don't ask for more resources,
that's called resourceful.
And you get things done, right? So, however, when you don't ask for help or for more resources, then they don't see you all of a sudden as a material for management. You are a good working being, but you may not know how to engage others and supervise others and train others. So you get to be a little bit careful. Yes, it is really important to have a hardworking ethic, but make sure, knowing that it does come from your cultural values, understand that, you know, others may see that as, it's great, but just as, you know, as a working bee. So you're not going to get a promotion. People didn't want to, you know, I worked so hard. Why nobody says anything? So, you know, what she was talking about, you know, you have to self-produce. You have to go out there and networking, right? It's not only about our friends, but it's also about meeting others who may be able to help you. So we say yes a lot, right? Hey, can you do this? I know you're super busy, but can you do this? And somehow, even though we're like, why me, right? And you go, yes, of course.
Yeah.
So we don't know how to say no. We have to be careful about that, too. Because remember, the following through is extremely important for our men. All of a sudden, you see a flake. Yeah, she says yes, but you know what? She doesn't come through. So be careful about that. And the last thing is, again, we don't ask for help. Whether it's for us to develop ourselves, or other people, you know, to create a bigger team. And there are others out there, so a lot of the time we tend to feel lonely and we just don't know how to ask for help because we...
About hard work. I learned hard work from my mother. In fact, everything I've learned is from my mother. And when I look at the work that she did, the effort that she put in, the perseverance, and I look at how it applies in today's world, in the business world, and it's not just about hard work. You got to differentiate yourself from everybody else. And she differentiated herself from everybody else. I mean, that's all I had in the house, but I'll tell you, while she was working, she was creating, she was painting a picture for her kids. She was building a dream that to this day stays in my mind. So she was working hard. I had the opportunity to see the effort, the constant effort, day in, day out, but the picture that she painted with her words is what separated her from everybody else.